Rafi and Klee live stream. Hopefully we don't say f***.
Okay, I Yay. Think we are live and I think we can be heard.
Hopefully. Hi, everybody.
Hi, you guys. Hi, Robot Rabbit and Cindy.
Hi, Lagalulu, Carol, Marty, Bill, Sarah, Christina, Ginny, Zara. What's up, y'all?
What's up, yo?
CJ,
Susan.
Susan, Ginger.
Hi, Ginger.
Hi.
Well, welcome to the public live stream where we will sit here and try to answer any questions that you throw at us.
Or anything you want to tell us.
Hi, Gaynor.
Hi, Gaynor.
Audio and video are good. Thank you, Jinja.
Great. Hi, Abby. Glad you could make
it. It's been forever since I caught a live stream. Yeah, happy that you're here. By the way, I love the picture of the 3D print that you sent me. Awesome.
Oh, yeah. I saw that, too, and didn't get a chance to respond, but it is truly awesome.
Hi, Sandy.
Hi, Sandy. Hi, Cheryl. Hurrah, I am here. I am here, said the Who's. Hi, Fire and Fumes. Hi, Amy.
So if you two say the F word, do we drink? Oh, and
you
I don't have a drink.
You can certainly play that game. We don't have any drink. I have water, which is good.
Yeah.
Finally had a chance to make a live stream. Glad you could be here.
Awesome. Thanks for being here, Fire and Fumes.
Hi, Drewzilla. Hi, Charlie.
Hi, diddly ho, oh, neighbor. Diddly ho.
I likely can't stay, but I'm here for now. How goes?
It goes well.
Okay,
it goes
so
well.
Let's do announcement time.
Yeah, we're going to do some quick announcements. My daughter just moved in.
With her partner.
With her partner.
So far, it's been great.
Yes. Sky Blue with Daisies is here. Hi.
Hi, Sky Blue.
I'm here. I made it. Hello.
Hi, Mary. So, yes, that's the first announcement. That's a life change for us.
Yes, it is. You know, obviously, there's an adjustment period because, you know, now there's two other humans living in the house. So, trying to figure that out. It's been great so far. Mm-hmm. But, you know, we take it one day at a time.
Absolutely. The second announcement is that Rafi launched his pre-order for his 2024 calendars recently. Some of you guys probably know that and saw the things. But the calendar is beautiful. Good job.
The calendar is awesome. They have not arrived yet, but I'm dying to show them to you. But, you know, buy my calendar.
That's
subliminal. By the way,
totally. I think that we have a pretty good chance of actually selling out of calendars this year.
I think so too. We've already sold because I have it limited. It's limited edition, so it's only 100 calendars, and we have already sold a little bit over half of them. Mm-hmm. So thank you so much to all of you that ordered calendars. You guys effing rock.
And
so thank you.
If you do want a calendar and you haven't ordered one, you can do so on our website. RafiandKlee.com.
Yep. And I think I'm going to be designing a poster that's going to go with the calendar, and I'll be making that announcement next week. So everybody that already ordered a calendar, you'll also get the poster, and everybody that orders a calendar from here until the pre-order date, I believe I have set for December 1st. So mm-hmm. for anybody that orders a calendar, then you get the poster as well. I want to do a cool like artist poster.
Yeah.
So yeah, that's part of it. Really good on the announcements. I totally forgot about like plugging my calendar.
Oh yeah, yeah. big family meals. Yeah. Here's the thing is that Rafi usually cooks for many people
I
anyway.
Do.
So
I don't know how to cook little meals.
Nothing
you
much
guys.
Has changed there.
Yeah.
Okay, the last announcement is...
Just like, welcome Rogue Junior.
Indeed. Mm-hmm. The other thing is, I just want to send out a huge thank you. We released a new song 2 weeks ago, and I wanted to thank everyone who's checked it out on the streaming platforms or watched the music video that Rafi put together. It's been really cool.
Yeah.
And it's doing well, and I'm really proud, and I'm really humbled for all the support. So thank you. And if you haven't heard the song yet, it's called All We Are, and it's All We Are by Better on the Drums on any of the streaming platforms that you might be listening on. And the video is on our music channel,
Rafi and Klee Music. You watch the music video and let me know how cool. I'm very proud of the music video. The song is all Klee. but
it's not all Klee. It was a team effort. We're very proud of
mostly
the song.
Mostly her being awesome. Yeah, I'm very proud of that song. Very proud.
And also, I have another song in queue that we're gonna be releasing late December or early January, and I think you guys will find it very fun indeed.
You guys were looking for a sleeping bag. If any of you guys know of a sleeping bag that looks like you are a caterpillar,
that would be much.
Send us a link our helpful. Way to the website, because that's going to be for the music video. Yeah, it's going to be awesome.
Okay, hello to Galefriend and Jesse and Siobhan. Hi, Rafi from the UK. I'm so grateful for that video you made about to keep carrying on with your artwork. Hope you are well.
Thank you. Yes, it is important to keep carrying on with your artwork. I would say that 99% of the struggle for artists is what's going on in here.
Definitely.
And, you know, if you give yourself any kind of excuse or any kind of reason to quit, you know, it becomes an uphill battle for you. And obviously you guys all know that that's hard. Even I, as motivational as I am, I have my days where I'm like, I quit, you know.
And that's part of it too.
Yeah, you give yourself permission to quit for a few hours and then you carry on.
Then you carry on. Siobhan says hi to me too. Oh, it's all good, Siobhan. Hi.
Rebel Rabbit said, I have to confess, I am going to sell out of a couple of artworks. I need sympathy. Congratulations on selling out of a couple of artworks. I know how that battle is, where it's like you're really excited to sell something, but then at the same time you're like, shit, now I gotta create more stuff.
Well, I'm curious because it actually says sell out for a couple of artworks.
Oh.
And here's my two cents without additional context. Selling out is a relative term, and so you have to do what feels right for you in your art career and for you personally, and selling out's like not this big horrible thing.
No.
Honestly, if it feels icky in your guts, maybe don't do a thing, but otherwise, if you feel good about it and you're like, I need to move forward, then do what you must do.
I did a show once with this guy who was very talented, but he was so full of himself because he was like, I don't even, like, I just feel like a sellout being here. And but like all this stuff. And I was like, you are like a dark cloud. It's like, but he was upset because he wasn't selling anything. So he was like, I'm just a sellout. I'm this. And I'm like, that whole sellout thing for artists is just complete bullshit. Any artist from the past that you look at, they did book covers, they did commercial art, they did whatever they needed to do in order to make money to be able to continue doing this amazing thing that we do. So yeah, don't
worry about it.
Don't worry about it.
Jesse said, while we love art for the sake of art, unfortunately we live within the confines of capitalism, so get your coin.
I mean, if you could get your coin
and feel good
about it, you know, the part of it that, like, so I always say, like, stay completely authentic. If you could wrap your mind around doing something and infusing your own thing into it, just because it's something that maybe you typically haven't done, you play around with that stuff. You know, I'm never, ever, ever, ever going to put somebody down because they needed to create a certain type of art to get them through a tough period or to make some money. However, the one thing that I want you to stay aware of is that remember that the more you do something, the more that becomes your niche. So it's like, just, that's fine if you do it, but make sure that it's just a stepping stone to get to the next thing, that you don't end up getting stuck in a place where you don't want to be.
Mama Snaps only cooks for dozens of guests, never less.
Yeah.
It seems to me that it's just easier to cook for many.
Bill said, I ordered one. Actually, looking forward to next year. I will be working into my daily workflow. That's awesome. Thank you.
Yes.
Valorf said, hi. Hi, Valorf.
Hi, Valorf. The video is beautiful. Oh, my God. Thank you, Sky
Thank
Blue.
You.
Christina said, I finally posted something that has a glaring mistake in it that I couldn't correct, got negative comments on it, and I plan posting more imperfect art.
Great.
That's awesome.
Great.
New England said, hi, guys. Can't wait for the calendar. Klee, love your sweater. Thank you so much. And shout out to you for the wonderful, wonderful thing that you sent us that we will be featuring and shouting out in our virtual open studio.
Yeah. You're going to be getting such a huge shout out. We both screamed.
We did scream.
So
we had the kids in the car with us and we screamed and they were like, let us see.
Not that I don't correct my art or want to perfect it, but I want to get over perfecting it for others. Yeah, perfect. Totally. Perfect. And you know what? If somebody's willing to put a negative comment on something, on somebody else's art, then I'm like, man, screw you. Like, come on, join me in the arena. Join me in the arena and then you could say something. Because the fact of the matter is that people that are in the arena putting their artwork out there, putting their vulnerability out there, they would never criticize anybody else's art. So, like, you know, those people get eat a bag. That's where I'm at with it.
Hi, Gillies. Bill said that song's in my daily listen list. It gets me going in the morning. That is so awesome. Thank you.
Thank you. Robot Rabbit, I cook for one. So sandwiches and boiled eggs.
Delicious. I'm not going to lie. I cooked for one for a long time, and it was kidney beans or cereal or whatever I could make with an egg. Because that's how I roll.
You made a lot of beans.
I made a lot of beans.
There have been a lot of farting.
And a lot of eggs. I took digestive enzymes.
Oh, God. Eggs and beans.
Yeah. Abby said, I'm learning it's okay to switch gears. I've completely moved to a different medium than what I started with. Felt guilty about all the money spent, but I'm so happy on this 3D printing journey.
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. Don't ever feel guilty about any creative decisions that you make. It's all part of the journey.
Mm-hmm.
Just follow your gut. Follow your gut.
Yes. And toss a coin to your artist.
Toss a coin to your... Yep.
I don't want to like super cover that song.
I know.
But that was a good one, Christina. Yes, agree, said Jesse. Feel good about your art, but also don't feel bad if you got to pay bills.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. You know, and that's the thing, like, you guys get to see me in a video where, like, I'm on a specific topic and I am having that conversation with someone that sent me a question or with whatever brain fart I have going on in that morning. But, like, it's never, I try never to be very, I don't play around indefinites because it just doesn't work that way. Like, your career, I hope that that comes across in the videos that, like, your art career is yours to decide what you're going to do with. Screw anyone else, including me, that might tell you, like, well, you know what you should do is blah, blah, blah. And it's like, no, it's your career. You get to decide. It's your art, your career, your life. Mm-hmm. Most importantly, like, you want to live your life however it is that you want to live your life and do what you are going to do.
Hi, St. James. Robot Rabbit said, I'll compromise by adding my signature angry bunny somewhere in these boring landscapes.
I love it. I love it. You know, I had a commission once. It wasn't, it was photography. Like, a company had hired me to do some photography, and it was like a corporate company. Like, I forget what they did, like landscaping or something. And they had all this machinery and stuff. And what I did was, I added little like shadow images. Like, in one of them, there's a tiny little Mary Poppins in the background. In another one, it's like a field and there's a guy lifting one of the bulldozers, but you can't really tell unless you look really, really closely.
Mm-hmm.
So it was really fun because then they put all these images up on their website and I was like, this fucking rules.
Michelle wants to know, should you put your full address or P.O. box in your email newsletter, or is it okay to abbreviate it somehow? I don't want everyone to know my full real address.
So we do a P.O. box. Mm-hmm. Michelle, like, you know, and ideally we have our address here, but we want to have a P.O. box when we're as a return address on all the art and jewelry that we mail out,
mm-hmm.
but also to have on your newsletter or even on your email or on your website so that people can send you something if they need to. Yeah, not your address. That's why I would get a P.O. box. And honestly, in some cases, like, it's actually, I think GD, blah, one of those things, one of those rules on the internet is that, like, if you're sending out stuff for it not to be marked as spam, there should be some way to contact the person sending it.
Mm-hmm.
So I would do a P.O. box. I recommend a P.O. box to anybody that has their art business in their house and they're going to be shipping stuff. That way you could have that on your packages and not like your actual
your house.
Address. Yeah.
Yeah, that's how we roll.
Eat a large bag, said Amy.
Ruby, are we allowed to mail you guys gifts? You're welcome to. That is awesome. Our P.O. box.
Did you notice how awkward we got? Like we have a P.O. box online. You guys are more than welcome to send us stuff. And
it's whatever, on our website.
Whatever gets sent, we try to feature in a video in some way, shape, or form.
Yes, we do. Hi, Cynthia. First timer here. I've been lurking for quite a while. I make jewelry, but would love to start painting. Thanks for all the great content that you share so willingly. Thank you, Cynthia.
Welcome, Cynthia.
And welcome. Kathleen said, I make chipped beef for myself. Only person who likes it. Hi, Artist Haven.
Hi, Tish.
Christina said, plus I think obsessively thinking about perfecting my art for others doesn't do much for the process except to add stress.
Yeah, I mean, that's whenever I take on a... Oh, shit. Thank you, Diego.
Thank you, Diego.
Thank you for everything you do, guys. Thank you.
Oh, that's so kind of you. Thank you so much.
Christina, like, that's... Whenever I take on a commission, if I'm too much in my head... At any point, if I'm working on anything and I'm too much in my head, which is that, like if you're worried about what other people think, then you're going to be in your head, right? Because if not, you're like in the flow of doing that thing. And sure, you run into roadblocks and stuff like that, but you don't compound the issue by adding this imaginary idea of what someone else might think of it. It's like, screw that, you know, like whatever. People are going to say what they're going to say. They're going to love it or hate it. You have no control over that. You might as well just create the thing that you want to create.
Absolutely.
So you're on it. You're on that path beautifully.
Mary said, at the moment, I have a giant plate filled with avocado, peppers, cucumber, green onion, Stilton cheese, Papadum, and a dark, thick, chewy beer cooking for one. Ta-da! That all sounds amazing. I will say, too, I like beers that can double as a meal in of themselves.
She does. She
like,
does.
You know, I like a Guinness.
Amy's like, damn, Klee goes hard.
Lupita said, I want to learn digital art so badly because digital art seems so much more attainable than having to spend an extra 10 minutes setting up my painting space.
I mean, go for it. Go for it. Mm-hmm. Try it out. I actually have a really hard time. I admire people that do digital art because for me, like I got to set up my computer and stuff. Because my art studio is already set up, it's much easier for me to get in there and start working. But I do, when I do digital art, it's like this big to-do, like this big ordeal that I'm trying to simplify. But yeah, absolutely. Like whatever makes it easier for you to create, that's, mm-hmm. I mean, that's the way that we should all look at it. It's like make the process as easy as possible. There really should be just one step for you to get into your creative space.
Definitely.
And be doing stuff.
Abby said, that's why I stopped with the paper flower shadow boxes. I was starting to get known for them. And while the end result was pretty, I hated making them too monotonous.
Yeah.
And it's okay, even if you've been doing something and then you decide, like, this isn't for me anymore. That's totally your prerogative. You have to go with what you're feeling. Did we jump a lot?
Okay.
Let's see. Michelle said, thank you so much. You could start a mailbag segment, said Jesse. Lupita said, I love hiding a heart in my paintings.
Right.
Christina wants to know, should I even bother responding to the negative comments? It's so exhausting. Part of me just likes it when their hater comments don't land.
No. I wouldn't even respond. You know, and if they get out of line, just delete and block them. But so basically, the way that I deal with negative comments is, A, if they get out of line, then I just delete and block them, right? Because I'm like, I don't need your bullshit. If it's something where it's like ridiculous and I know I could have fun with it, I might have fun with it. In some cases, it also depends on how much time I have, right? It's like, if I could have fun with it and maybe I'm sitting around waiting, then, you know, I'll just mess with somebody or whatever. And then, you know, usually what happens is that they're like, oh, why are you getting so upset? And I'm like, I'm not getting upset. You
know? I thought we were having fun.
Artist
Haven said, I cook for six still. That way I only have to cook once a week. Bam.
Boom.
That's great. Goldfinder said, Rafi, like me, you can say no man ever had a better wife than I have. Aw. Klee, you are so cute. Thank you, Goldfinder. Aw,
thank you.
Aw, and I'm sure your wife is amazing, too. Connie said,
Goldfinder's left some comments about his wife, and I'm like, she's awesome. She's awesome. Your wife is awesome.
Connie, hi, Connie.
Hi, Connie.
Hello. I hope all is well with everyone. Christina said, I think I should hide some secret codes in my art and see if people notice some clue to a niche anime that has a lot of philosophy in it with a bunch of theories and such and comment on it.
I love it. I love it. Do it. That kind of stuff is really fun. We know an artist here who does these landscape paintings, and she always hides something in the painting that, like, you don't see right off the bat. In fact, some of them, like, she had to point it out. I was like, holy shit, that's awesome.
I think it's super cool. Yeah,
I love that kind of stuff.
Robot Rabbit wants to know, caffeine and nicotine count as food, right?
Yes.
Well, there was a long stint of time where I definitely believed that they did.
I mean, it wasn't that I believed that they did. They actually did.
They did.
They sustained me for, like, 3 years. So, yeah, that worked.
Nanu.
Oil paint is never one step.
Still love it though.
Yeah, I get that.
Hi, Languages of Lights. You guys are super inspiring. Hello from the hot tub in Alabama.
Oh, love it. Love it.
Oh, no, not feelings again, said Cameron. Always feelings. Always.
That's how we get rid of the people that don't belong in our awesome, you know, group, is we talk about feelings. And then they're like, feelings? Oh.
If you don't want to talk about feelings, we're probably not your guy.
Yeah. Yeah.
Just saying. Gail Friend said, that's awesome. When I draw trees, I hide a heart in them too.
Oh, Gail, I love that. See, I love that. I love that kind of stuff. You know, it's like, and that's why I say, like, you create the artwork for yourself. So even if you're doing a landscape or something, find a way to make it your, you know, like, and I'm talking to Robot Rabbit. Like, if you got to do something that you're like, ugh, I got to do this thing. Do it, but add that little element that nobody else is going to see, but you see it every time that you look at the art.
St. James. Hi, St. James.
Hey, St. James.
Hit that thumbs up, like button. Thank you.
Oh, thank you.
Tiger Stripe said, yes, never feed the trolls. Never, ever. It only encourages them. It's true. Get yourself a trusted mod, said Noctilon's Campfire. Hey,
that's
Rafi.
That's a good. I have not done that, but that is a good thing to do. Get somebody that will go through and just look at those comments and get rid of them.
Nighty night, Shaban. Glad you could be here.
Hi,
with
Shaban.
Us. Carol said, hey, Rafi, I'm thinking about incorporating Braille into my black and white landscapes, but not sure on how or how much Braille. Any suggestions? Oh, I don't know where to start.
I would say go for
it. That sounds awesome.
Go for it, Carol. That is something that I've thought about with some of my abstracts. I've wanted to incorporate Braille. First off, like, I love touching the art. I'm horrible at it. If I go to somebody's art show, if one of you guys invite me to an art show, chances are, because I can't, like, when I see texture, I want to touch it. I'm a very tactile person. So, like, I've wanted to do that where I incorporate that. Carol, I think it would be amazing. I think you should do it. I think it should just be either something in the background or maybe incorporated into the color or the texture of the piece itself.
Maybe it would depend on the piece too, because you could put an entire poem or statement into a piece, or you could just put one word or one line. And I think it would be like, you know, your gut feeling about what the piece calls for. Yeah. But I think that that would be incredible.
Yeah, I think that that's brilliant. I'm like, go for it. Go for it.
Jesse says, add 42 to your paintings. It's the secret to the universe.
That's
indeed
right.
It is. Bill said, I had a student tell me last night that I paint like no other watercolor artist / teacher they have ever seen. That's good, right?
Yes.
I personally think that's amazing.
Yes. And Bill, your art is phenomenal.
Indeed.
I was going to say something else, but phenomenal.
You were going to, yeah, you're going to curse over
it. Was
going to
be like, bleep, 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 bleep. It's amazing. Yeah.
Abby, I'm not sure if it froze for anyone else. Hopefully we're not frozen. Christina said, and also on hater comments, let's say someone mentions a mistake I left in that isn't technically hate, but they have no idea on the context, and usually I couldn't correct it or just wanted to finish it. Probably they're just trying to be helpful, but at the same time, you're like, whatever.
At the same time, you're like, whatever. Like, I created it. Like, if you created it, if someone else created it, then sure, they could list out the mistakes that are in there. But, like, I don't need you. I don't need you to come to me and tell me what the mistakes are. Not saying that there's anything wrong. If you were asking for constructive criticism, that's one thing. But I think the anonymity of the internet somehow gives some people like, well, let me help you out here. let me come and mansplain this to you. You know, like they're in those cases, I'm like, all right, you know, I might say thank you for that. But like, in all honesty, I'm not worried too much about it.
Indeed.
You know, like I've had people like, oh, you know, you got this wrong or whatever. I was like, not really. That's more of my creative imperative to do that.
I had a man tell me at a show, I hate how you bezeled this piece. And I was like, that's cool.
It sucked too.
Are you a jeweler?
Wait, was it one of our collaborations where I'd done like a little work of art?
He loved the painting that Rafi did.
He loved the painting.
He's like, I hate how you bezel it. My response is like, are you a jeweler? And he was like, yeah. And I was like, oh, cool. So you have a different style as me.
Fair.
That's cool. Also, I'm like just learning. At the time, I was like 1 year in. So I was like, that's fine. Let's see. I lost my place. Languages of Light said I put codes and sayings in my artwork too.
Oh, I love it.
Kathleen said I was not raised knowing how to work with feelings. Thank you for letting me learn.
Oh, absolutely, Kathleen.
So happy to have you as part of the fam and learning along with us because it's a forever.
I mean, it's forever. It's an infinite onion. You're constantly going through layers of your emotions and stuff, and that's the problem is that a lot of people like repress their feelings, and that's what we learn what to do. And you feel your way through life.
Yeah.
You know, you feel your way through an art career. You feel your way through your insecurities and doubts. Like, that's the only way that you could do that.
Hi, Yo-Yo Jin.
Hey, Yo-Yo Jin.
We love you, too.
We love you.
You guys, if we miss your question or your comment, please feel free to copy-paste it in the ticker tape because it gets going because we're having a great party here. But sometimes we can't scroll back to see. So just feel free if we don't see your thing.
Also, you guys, check out what Yo-Yo Jin has been up to on Instagram. I love Yo-Yo Jin.
Yeah. Lupita said, I'm not a big creator by any means, so I've had a total of 3 haters in the comments, and each time I felt honored, like, wow, I made it. Right?
Yes!
That's how I felt about it, too.
Awesome.
Yeah. Let's see. I'm needing to watch the stream to see chat. Isn't that, I don't know.
Wait, where are you?
At, watercolor up here. I'm not sure.
I have no idea.
Abby said, just throwing out another little thing I've come to understand. It's okay to give yourself time to learn and grow instead of jumping in for money from the program to the printer to painting.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. You take your time with it because that's the problem is that like a lot of people want to approach, I mean, you want to approach anything like, I want to do this now because I want to make the money. I want to make the money and I'm going to do this. And this is the most viable thing. And in reality, a lot of times it's like you want to take that approach because it gives you validation in the eyes of other people, because then you're able to tell, well, I am doing this thing and, you know, I am making money. So get off my back. And really the reality is you got to get to a place is like, well, I am doing this thing and it makes me happy. And I know that I'm on the right path. So get off my back.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like it's basically the same thing without having to use that money as a validation, because money comes and goes. I mean, honestly, somebody with a corporate career, you could like tank them, even if they're like, I make $75,000 a year. And you could be like, really? Because you kind of seem broke all the time.
How much time are you going to be able to buy back with that?
Yeah, exactly. Not that I don't want to put anybody down that has a, you know,
it's about being satisfied.
Site. Yeah, exactly.
Goldfinder said, art is light telling a story, which I love.
Yes.
That's awesome.
Thank you for sharing that.
New England said, I had a quilting instructor who said there's blood in every quilt. Talk about hiding something personal in your art. I believe it. Yeah, there's a lot of art forms and things that are
anything,
on the dangerous side.
Anything that I've ever sewn has my blood and tears in it. Like, you know, there's a lot that goes into it.
There is some jewelry that had my blood on it. Fortunately, with jewelry, you can wash and polish off the blood and tears.
Hi, Linda.
Hi, Linda.
I love when someone sees your painting and first thing they do is touch it and then say, oh my God, I'm sorry. Is that okay if I touch it? I love texture in your paintings, Ralph. Yeah. Thank you. Yeah, I can't. I do that because immediately I go, I do the thing where like my glasses go down and I like look at the texture and the brush strokes and all that stuff. And then I just want to touch it. Yeah.
Robot said, I had to touch that Samothrace statue. Can't remember the full name at the Louvre. It took 0.5 seconds for the security to jump me.
That's why I'm afraid of going to places like that because I know.
Yeah, but if you can just touch it before they get you, then it's worth it,
probably. If we do that, we should take a camera and just like make it a game. Be like, how long do you think it'll take?
Touching art at the Louvre?
Yeah, touching art at the Louvre.
Oh my God.
That would be an amazing video.
It would. Noctilon said, I went to a video game store named Game Over and not GameStop and saw that they allow artists to sell and post VidGame fan art at the store walls. I will take advantage of the opportunity.
Yes, that's do awesome. That. That's awesome.
Jin just said, Klee for the guy who hated Bezel. Handsome says, three words, cool story, bro. Yeah. Art therapy helps with emotions. Agreed.
Yes, it does. Yes, it does.
Kelly said, I had someone tell me the water in a wave in painting was the wrong color. I saw Kelly, I saw was that. Like, what?
I saw that, and I was like, what fucking color are they talking about? Like, what color water? It's not like water is like the same color throughout.
Two words for that human. Emerald Coast, where we used to live.
Exactly. That's exactly what your water looked like. It looked like Emerald Coast water.
Hi, Sarah. Hi,
your
Jacqueline.
Your water looks wrong. You fucking eat a bag.
Yeah.
Makes me. Yeah. I get all mama bear.
Yeah.
Whenever anybody like goes after the rogues, I'm like, I will end you.
I know. Yeah. Jacqueline said, hey, I can't stay long, but listening for a few minutes. Just had a craft show last Saturday and another one this weekend. Have amazing show.
Have amazing show. Congratulations.
Thanks for stopping in.
Yeah.
Nanu said, I have not done any art in weeks. I am doing a bunch this weekend.
Awesome, Nanu.
Love it. Christina said, it's kind of like, I know every stroke in my art. I know most things wrong with it. When I can't see something, but I know something is wrong, I ask. I had a guy think the foreshortening was a mistake.
Yeah, that's the issue is like, you know, if you look at the art and it's doing what you want it to do, and even if there's a part of it that's maybe not doing exactly what you want it to do, but you got to close enough, you know, because that's where when it comes to my art, like I am meticulous with a lot of things, but there's a lot of stuff that I'm like, good enough, you know, especially if I've been with a piece for a long time and I'm like, you know what, this pretty much says what I wanted to say.
Mm-hmm.
Even if it's not quote unquote perfect or whatever, or like if there's something, every work of art that I've created, I could always do something better on it. Always. That's, you're always growing with your art. So you know, that, and that's the thing, like other people, they don't know the journey that you're on. So it's like, okay, well, cool. Thanks. Thanks for that.
Cool story, bro.
Cool story, bro.
Like Handsome said. Jen Fries. Hi, Jen Fries.
Hey.
Just listening while painting.
Awesome.
Glad you could be here with us. Yeah, Watercolor said, yeah, money comes and goes.
It does.
Jesse said the art ritual is not complete until there is a blood or flesh sacrifice. That's true. And also, I drop it on the ground at least once,
yeah.
Usually.
Or sneezes on it.
I really try not to sneeze on it
yeah.
anymore. But again, the beauty of jewelry is that it gets washed and polished at mm-hmm. the end, so...
I turned down a big promotion at work because I would have to be in the office 5 days a week. Nope, not happening. I like working in my studio. Thank you.
Heck yeah, Nanu.
Yeah.
I think there's a good chance I have chocolate in everything I do, said Gail Fred.
I love it, Gail.
That's a wonderful thing. Lots of cat hair in my art. Sorry, everyone. Says Sky Blue.
I mean, that's fine. That's fine. I think about it, and you know, like when they're x-raying paintings and like doing this, the close scans of it, those are the things that they're going to use to identify whether or not it's a, you know, it's a genuine your painting.
Yeah. So. Lisa can only jump on briefly, but have a quick question. Have you done a podcast about operating two personas? One is a public studio, craft, tech, teaching, and one for the personal artwork for galleries. We have not done a podcast strictly on that. We have talked about that mm-hmm. in podcasts and probably videos too, but we have not done a full podcast. That's a pretty good question it's and a, subject matter.
It's a good question. How would you approach that if you were to give a quick response to that?
Well, I'm a big fan of operating a singular like website and social media presence and incorporating everything I do, but making sure that things are organized and clarified in such a way that people find what they're looking for. Because I don't want to operate more than one website or account. However, you guys know that we have our e-commerce website and then we have our Rogue community platform because they're very different things.
Yeah.
And so I think it really depends on your comfort level, right? If you want crossover or crossover is relevant, then if you're operating two things, have them promote each other in case your people over here might be looking for this too. If you can manage the time and cost of operating two websites, two social accounts, then by all means, do it. I think it's a really personal choice, and we've kind of gone back and forth on this, even on YouTube, right? Should we have a separate channel for our adventures versus the main channel and so on and so forth? And there's instances where separating things makes total sense, and there's instances where it's just better and easier to combine things. So it really is a personal choice, and I think whatever you choose, A, you get to change your mind if you decide, nope. And B, nobody gets to tell you what the right answer is.
Nobody gets to tell you what the right answer
is. Including us.
Yeah. But if you want, I think if you can, I know you have to leave. If you don't mind sending us an email to our website with this question, and then we could set something up where we could do something.
Like dive into it.
Dive into it, yeah.
Marty wants to know, how do you feel about journaling ideas and revisiting later? I love it.
Yes.
Do you ever find that some of the ideas you were excited about lose their spark?
Yeah,
sometimes.
Sometimes, you know, and it really depends on where you're at. There are times where, like, my brain is not in the right place for it, and something sounds really good, and I'm like, yeah. I figure if you move on, then you're just making room for...
Totally.
For the other ideas.
Tanya wants to know, do you guys ever have a piece that you love so much that you created, you decide to keep it for yourself?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
It doesn't happen super often, but it does.
There are pieces that I've created that Klee has decided that she wanted, and so we kept it.
Indeed. Yeah. And you have done also. many times I was wondering where we can find your PayPal direct or some other form of direct pay other than buying merch. We have that set up on the Rogue Community
the
site.
The Rogue Community site. Yeah, so like this... The
Rogue
bottom,
artist
not the,
community.
Not the Rafi and Klee, but the other one. We set up a page like that because people were asking us. So, like, on the there's the pricing to join the Rogues, and then there's a
one-time donation page. If you wanted to go that route, it's there because we have had people ask us for it. And gosh, thank you to all of
thank
you.
Thank you. Yeah.
Let's see.
Got to meditate while listening to you guys.
Ooh, I hope we're providing good meditation.
That's awesome.
Mm-hmm. Kathleen said, also possible art ritual ending, another item of clothing joins the painting pile. They all do eventually.
They all do. They really do.
Mm-hmm.
DNA signature. Yep.
Mm-hmm.
That's all my artwork. All my artwork has, you know, it's funny because like I'm wearing hoodies and stuff. And there are times where like I'll see like a chest hair in my artwork. And I'm like, how did that get in there?
That's so machismo of you.
It is. I'm like, my artwork is so manly. That
my
just
chest
full of,
hairs just go just, boop. It's like, what can you do when you've got that much manliness while you paint? I had to. yeah,
okay.
Actually, I'm the one making the ruckus in the studio with hammers and saws and files. Raphael will be painting, and I'm like, poof, 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 at my desk.
Danielle said, hi, always listen, but first time posting. Oh, no, I lost it. Always listen, first time posting. You are both inspirational with great advice. Feel the artist's battles. I'm architectural designer, architect. My art is so complicated, but I love it.
That's
oh, well,
so
that's
rad.
Awesome. And thank you.
Thank you for being here. They're going to check for Hot Cheetos fingerprints on my pieces, said Lupita. Hot
Lupita.
Cheetos are so good.
Hot Cheetos.
Connie said, oh no, something, but I missed it. Goldfinder said, my daughter touched a Van Gogh self-portrait at the Chicago Institute of Art. I was terrified she would be arrested. She got away with it, though?
Yep.
Oh, no, you started the live stream over again.
What?
I don't know. Hopefully not.
Hopefully not.
Watercolor said he, I'm looking at splitting my membership tiers into different sites. It's all a work in progress. Yes, can change at any time. Some of you guys know, like, the Adventure Channel went away.
And then we were like, it came back.
We feel great about this decision. And then we were like, but we miss it, though.
Yeah, I know. I know. And apparently what was going on was that I wanted to be sharing the podcast that we record on the main channel and got rid of, like, all the channels and put them all on the main channel. But then I missed having the Adventure Channel because it's the Adventure Channel stuff is very different. It's still us, but it's very different from what we do on the main channel.
Yeah.
So,
let's see.
We brought it back. So, like, things are going to flow and change and all that stuff.
Trexler wants to know, I recently did a nice portrait on canvas with a little bit of tooth. When I go to take images of it, I'm seeing every little bump shows up from the canvas. Any good advice on photographing a rough canvas?
Okay, so when it comes to a rough canvas, really it's the lighting, right? So, like, the best thing that you could do is set your camera up to sit still, right? So like a tripod with a timer, and actually reduce the amount of lighting that is coming from behind you, right? Or even to the sides, and allow the lighting to come from behind the canvas and just kind of reflect light. It'll give you that much more
diffused
lighting throughout the room.
That's what you want.
Your exposure will go up, right, to compensate. And you have to play around with that lighting until you get to a point where the exposure isn't overcompensating. And you get a nice, what you'll get is almost like a grayed out image, right? It won't be grayed out, but it'll be a little bit muted. And then when you bring it into your software, that's where you're going to heighten the contrast and, like, really, really adjust the colors. But I find that that's the best way. Obviously, it helps too. Like, you want to take pictures of stuff before you put varnish on it, you know, like any kind of shininess to it. So those are two of the things that I do whenever I'm dealing with where, like, there's just light that's coming, that's like coming off of the texture. I'm like, fuck.
Anything you can do to diffuse the light. Overcast daylight outside, 3-point lighting, light socks so that the bulbs aren't glaring right on the piece.
I honestly would super recommend when it's cloudy outside.
It's
like just kiss. Putting it somewhere, and you want to put it somewhere where you don't have, like, white objects, like, because remember, whatever is behind you is going to kind of, like, reflect in the painting like a mirror. So, like, kind of setting it up. A lot of times I would just do it underneath an awning outside when it was cloudy to keep all that, all the reflections off of it. Anything that's around it is going to reflect off of the painting.
Jin just said red ear alert. Yeah, your ears did turn red a little bit there.
One of them.
Trexler also wanted to know, I've recently been receiving some social media hate for some of my historical subjects. It's my passion and I enjoy telling stories through my work, but now I'm a little discouraged.
Don't get discouraged. You know what? If you're getting haters,
just that means you're doing them. Something that, yeah, just delete them.
Just delete them. Just delete them.
We fuck all get haters.
Fuck those guys. Like, you know, just delete them. I'm sick and tired of people hiding behind a screen and deleting. That's why my biggest advice to you is if you are going to start really sharing your stuff and you're going to be doing something that is different than what the people you even know do, just block them. Block your friends. Block your family. So that it gives you your permission to be authentic without somebody being like, oh, well, that's weird. You know, if that's the kind of thing that you need, it doesn't mean that you need to block them forever, but at least, you know, that way you give yourself time to establish yourself. Yeah.
Robot Rabbit said, several people came to me saying they always wanted to paint, but they're bad at art. I was thinking about doing a few workshops. First one themed ugly painting.
Do it. That's awesome. I love that. I love that. I think you should. I think you should. For me, one of the first classes I did was called Let Loose and Paint with Rafi. And it was to allow people to come in and just have fun. Like we like threw dirt at the canvas and like did all kinds of fun things. And I think that that kind of thing would be really popular because, you know, nobody wants to go learn how to do something from somebody who's all uptight.
Nay.
And
yeah. Let loose and paint. Pew!
Yeah, exactly.
Yo-Yo Jin said, when I'm looking at conceptual art, I feel like I'm doing it wrong and I feel guilt about what I'm painting. I tried to express the theory in my works, but it seems hard to deliver the stories. Maybe visually outlook is hard to put meaning into it. I also apply the master course to study more, but I failed to get in. Maybe I'm too far from the art world. Is this feeling only for me or someone else also experiences this kind of feeling?
All the time. You know, and it really depends on where I'm at. When it comes to things, you know, because there's this weird balance. You have the art world and then you have this art world and then you have this art world and all these different art worlds. But there's this art world, this perception in your brain. And then you're working on stuff and you're trying to tell your story and you're trying to get across something that is, you know, honestly, it's subjective. No matter what, when you look at art, the art is subjective. The story behind the art is really for the artist to really determine their own story, their own meaning, so that when they are working on something, they can feel that additional feeling that comes with that story.
Yeah.
But when it comes to other people, and just that place, trying to find where it is that you fit in the art world, that's really hard. That's why I've always just embraced the uniqueness of who I am and what I am, and kind of like, you know, I could venture into the art world when it happens, when an opportunity opens up, but I don't want it. Does that make sense? I don't even know if that answered your question. Sorry for dropping my personal seriousness on here. No, those are good questions. Those are legit
also
questions.
Add, like, sometimes when you're developing a series or you're developing a piece, you're just developing it. You're not sure what it is yet. It's like when artists call the pieces that they're doing studies because they're just developing a thing. And there's nothing wrong with that. Like, it's about the development phase of it. I'm in that place all the time.
And so am I.
It's not until later that I like even understand what I was doing.
I mean, in all honesty, like I would say that 80% of my art, the story came after.
Mm-hmm.
I just created the thing. And then afterwards I sat there and I kind of like looked at it and stared at it. And I was like, what the hell is this thing about? Like, what is it? What, you know, I love it. I created it. Why did I do the marks like that? Why did I decide to put these colors in there? Like, what does this mean to me? And honestly, you know, I think that that's a fun aspect of being an artist, is that you get more insight into yourself. It's almost like looking at a Rorschach test, where like you're figuring out this thing that when you're into flow, you just kind of create subconsciously. And I think that that's beautiful, because essentially people that are paying attention, they're going to look at it that way. And they're going to be like, well, what the hell does this mean to me? But also, what the hell did this mean to the artist? And then it's this cool guessing game of like figuring out like, what is this all about?
I call it the sitting staring time.
Yo-Yo Jin, your art is
awesome.
You fucking blow me away.
We love you.
Yeah. So there's that. I don't know if that counts for anything, but there's that.
But in case it does. Chronic Crafty Life said, haters can't hurt me. I'm much meaner to myself than they could ever be. Oh, that's funny, but also don't be mean to yourself. Be loving.
Don't be mean to yourself.
Be kind to yourself, and then just don't give a boop what they say.
Carol said, oops, oh, blind moment. I was working on a stormy landscape and had to leave the room quickly. Came back and noticed my dog wagging tail got paint on canvas.
Canvas looked like a great rainstorm.
That was the fastest sale I ever had.
that's amazing. Great. Let loof and paint with Rafi, said Christina.
Yeah.
Yes.
That's going to be what the new one is going to be called.
Let loof.
Yeah, let loof.
I like it. Christina said, to be honest, I feel far away from the art world, but honestly, I don't mind it much.
Yeah, I mean, and that's the thing is, Christina, there's this perception of what the art world is. And honestly, there's a lot of players that believe that their version of the art world is the art world. And really, when it comes down to it, it's just like little clicks here and there and different, you know, there people want to generalize it into like just this one thing. And sure, if we're talking about anybody that deals with art, then that is the art world. That means that if you show your art at a festival, if you do a virtual show, if you do a mural in your bedroom, then that's the art world. And that's the reality of it. When it comes down to it, like any kind of separation is a construct that is just not even, it's not real. It's not real. There is no separation between artist and the art world.
Chronic Crafty said, Rafi and Klee legitimately gave me confidence to paint again because I never felt good enough. Love these people.
We love you too.
Kelly said, anyone else ever go to a paint and sip and not follow the instructor because we paint our own way? He walked up behind me and said, you're an artist. Carry on. That's great. I love it. Jesse said, I've complained about this before, but I'm tired of work and I only want to make art. I'm browsing new jobs, but I ask myself, why am I applying when I don't want to do any of it? It makes me feel like I'm being childish, especially since I've always tried to be responsible. I don't know if I need a change in perspective or what.
I mean, you know, when it comes to that, I get that, mm-hmm. Jesse. I mean, that's basically where I was for a long time in my life. And, you know, what I would say is if I could go back and change anything is that I would have taken advantage of the job and really, really changed my perspective to like, you know what, this is, if I say that I'm willing to do anything for my art career, then that means that if I need to get a side, a corporate side hustle, then I do. Mm-hmm. You know, like it's easy to say like, I'll do anything. And then like, you know, I see people do that all the time where they're like, I'll do anything. And I'm like, I of course am at a place where I'm like, I am willing to live in a cardboard box if it means that I get to create art for a living.
Yeah, give up the expenses.
Yeah.
Also, you have the right to be picky about your corporate side hustle. Don't just take any job that comes along. Be a little picky about it. Yeah. Be like, if I'm going to do this, I'm going to make sure that it's the most tolerable corporate side hustle that I can find.
Yeah, trust me.
And then it's temporary.
Trust me, it is a myth that there aren't enough jobs to go around.
There are plenty of jobs.
The corporations don't want you to know that because they don't want you to just, you know, decide to leave a job if it's shitty.
Yo-Yo Jin said, I'm so healed that I'm not the only one that feels it. Super thanks a lot.
Awesome. Awesome.
Christina said, also people analyze themselves through your art sometimes. Definitely.
Oh, yeah. Absolutely.
Definitely.
Absolutely. I've had some really great conversations from people coming into the booth and just looking at my art. I've had people like break down into tears in front of a painting.
Mm-hmm.
And then, you know, followed by a great conversation. I mean, a lot of my time spent in a booth or at an art show, I don't even talk about the art, to be honest with you. Mostly we end up talking about their lives and stuff. And
I talk about outer space a lot.
Yeah. Because Klee is from outer space.
Yeah. I mean, we all are technically because, you know, we're made of star stuff and what have you.
That's true.
Daniel says, I'm still trying to get my style out there, but all my work is commission architecture. So learn to blend me, them, and the place together,
create something special. Yeah, absolutely.
There's magic that happens in collaboration with the material, the person asking you to create, and you as the creator, and like being open to the inspiration and what comes out of that. Some of my most awesome work that I'm proud of has been commission based. I've grown so much as an artist through doing that.
Mm-hmm.
And also most everything that I've done musically that I'm really, really proud of has been a collaborative effort with this guy. And there's real magic there. So I just think it's a great growing experience. But, you know, also be looking out for yourself and don't put up with anyone's boo.
Exactly.
And I think you know that. But that's an experience that you also learn as you go, for sure.
Mary said, to be a tad more serious, haters are usually envious and sad. Their lives are empty, and so they lash out to anyone who is doing what they feared. I mean, absolutely. Mm-hmm. Absolutely, Mary. That was me. You know, believe it or not, when I was working corporate, I was a creative hater. I was full of myself. I thought that the only reason that people were selling art was because they sold out or somebody that they knew. I was pissed off because I could not understand how to get into it. I was resentful because I was working my corporate job and I didn't want to be doing it. And I took out, I took everything out on other people. So like if somebody came to me and was like, oh, I really want to do this thing, you know, I'd be like, yeah, you know, but like skeptical. I was a jerk about it. I even talking about this makes my heart hurt a little bit because I didn't realize that it was you cannot, unless you're in the arena doing the thing, you're going to be standing in the sidelines pointing a finger at the person that is doing the thing and telling them that they're not good enough. And that's just not, it's not true. And it's all based. That's why I've said in the past, and I'll say it all the time. If you get a hater, it has absolutely nothing to do with you, nothing to do with you or your artwork or anything like that.
For sure.
Yeah.
Thank you, Catherine.
Thank you, Catherine.
That's so kind of you, Catherine. So thank you for the live stream. This is such a lovely, supportive space you've created.
Oh, thank you. Well,
thank you to you guys.
We have an amazing community that has found us. It's just, we love you guys.
We love you, guys. And we don't know what we'd do without you either.
I think there's no room for bullshit here. Mm-mm. You know what I mean?
Scroll up just a hair. We can catch this one. Michelle wants to know one more thing. You inspired me to put on an art show with my art and my students' art to show it, but not to sell it. Would it be okay to charge an admission to help pay for the venue?
Heck yeah.
Absolutely. Yeah. You could also put out a donations welcome. Thank you. Your donation helps support what we're doing. Okay, scroll up one more hair. Danielle said, would love to work in a studio with artists. Shouldn't be a separation between the artists and the architecture. We all inspire each other in our creativity. You amazing people, you.
Absolutely. Agreed. Absolutely. And architecture, art, I mean,
all of it.
All of it.
I'm honored that we have such a diverse creative community that everything there is, just about, there's somebody in our community that's doing it or experimenting with it or pushing the boundaries of it. And all of it is art. Yeah. And it's all beautiful.
All of it is art. You know what? I will fight anybody that tries to give labels, right? I will fight anybody that tries to give labels. Because at the end of the day, you can call yourself whatever the hell you want. You call yourself an artist. You could call yourself a maker. I think Chronic Crafty Life said, you could call yourself whatever you want. No one else has the right to call you anything. You could call yourself a piece of broccoli if you want to. You know, I'm a piece of broccoli and I create art. It doesn't matter. The separation is what other people are. Well, that's a crafter and this is an artist. Well, that's an architect and this is an artist. And I'm like, I'm sorry, but if you are creating something that did not exist before you created it, whether it's a sketch, a design, or even a thought, or a paragraph, or a book, or music, or anything, if you created something that did not exist before it was created by you, then you are an artist. You are a creator. You are an artist. Plain and simple. I will fight anyone to the death.
Mic drop.
To the pain. I will fight them to the pain, not to the death. I will fight them to the pain.
Christina said, ooh, that reminds me of my sister and her husband and how they constantly discourage any of my ideas. Just be like, blah.
Yeah.
When they're being discouraging, blah.
Yeah, just block them. I block everybody. You know what? And if it's in person and you're like, look at this, and they're like, blah, blah, I'd be like, blocked, and just walk away.
Blocked.
Yeah.
That's the current version of Talk to the Hand, which I grew up with.
Block.
yeah. talk to the hand.
Ginger's like, artiste support group. Yes, indeed.
Indeed. Diego said, scroll up just a hair. A chest hair.
Nice. God. So manly when I scroll up.
Let Lufin paint. Yeah, that's how these really super fun inside jokes get started.
Yeah,
that we'll be talking about for a while.
Yeah, and then we'll mention them in a video and like a handful of people know what it is and they're like, ah, and then other people are like, I have no idea what you're talking
I
about.
I know, like hands, they're so lucrative.
Hands, they are so lucrative. You want to know what's lucrative right now in the art world?
Motherfucking hands.
Fucking hands.
Trexler said, recently my four-year-old has found some interest in watching daddy paint. Now he gets a few strokes to complete each painting. That's awesome.
Oh, that's awesome. I love that. That is badass.
That's so excellent.
That is badass.
Charity said this has been the best community that I have ever been involved in.
Oh, well, thank you, Charity.
I'm serious, you guys. I think this is, you guys are the best art community in the world.
Yeah.
And we're honored to be here with you. I think we could do anything.
Nanu says, pulls out label maker and prepared to cause chaos.
Excellent.
Great.
Nanu. Sarah says, I am a bowl of tomato soup. That's badass, Sarah.
Well, Christina said, I am a pumpkin from now on. Luke, first
it.
Time live visit, long time viewer. Hi, Luke.
Hey, Luke. Glad you could be here with us.
Robot Rabbit, my brother created a soundtrack for my show. It's a wonderful experience to hear my visuals. That is awesome. I love
That's
that.
Rad.
I love that. That's something that we've tried to do in the past with our shows, you know, where it's like the entire experience. The entire experience, the music, you know, every single sense, your eyes, the music, even the smells, the scents in the room,
mm-hmm.
Being completely immersed in the experience. I think that is badass.
Absolutely. Goldfinder said, when someone tries to tell me how I must act, I say to them, I'm sorry to disappoint you, but I already have a mother.
I love it. That's really good.
That's great. Luke said, you two are the best. Oh, thanks, Luke.
Thank you.
Christina said, sometimes I just start thinking about why I make art. Sharing art with others is so ingrained in the process now, but maybe it always was part of it.
It is.
I use a visual language after all.
It Opinions? Is. It is. Christina, all art is expression. All art, whether it's paintings, music, it's all expressions, right? It is you creating something and a big part of that expression is other people experiencing it, right? The thing about it is not understanding, right, that even in words, like I am saying this, there's a co-creative thing that happens here. I say some words and then the words go in here and then you decipher what the meaning is, right? And a lot of times I could be talking about one thing and you're thinking something else. You're hearing something else. The same thing happens with art. The same thing happens with music. The same thing happens with anything that we create out there. That's the beauty of it, is that it becomes this collaborative thing where you create it. And the only thing that you really have control over is how you feel about it and what it means to you. But then in sharing in that experience with someone else is pretty amazing. Pretty amazing.
It really is. It takes on a whole new dimension in that way.
Yeah.
Chronic Crafty Life said, I'm garbage, but I'm a garbage can, not a garbage cannot. Let's just take a moment to appreciate that.
I stole it from the internet, but I have chronic illness, so it's perfect.
New England said, I'm able to sell the things I make, but I haven't been able to put my paintings out there because I was told that the fluid pouring wasn't real art. Oh, my God, you made me snort laugh again.
Oh, God.
Hey, for all of us making not real art, you know there's actually a grant award available for you right now. It's called the Not Real Art Grant.
Yep.
And it's very much a very real program, and I think it's aimed at like removing that stigma.
Yeah.
And I thought it was so cool when we came across it.
Look it up, because I'm going to apply to that too, the Not Real Art Grant.
Yeah.
And it's a pretty good grant. You get quite a bit of grant money for it.
Yeah. And I think that applications are free. for that too.
I mean, that's so, that's even better.
There we go. We can all take our not real art.
Yep.
And apply. And ultimately, at the end of the day, man, there's going to be, you know, people love to come out of the woodwork and be like, that's not real art.
That's not real art. Well, that's
the
thing. And I'm like,
then you go make something.
You know what kind of people come out of the woodwork and say that, right? Because, like, it pisses me off because you go online and there's, like, these videos by these, like, people that sound very intellectual, right? And they're talking shit about a painting and saying, like, that's not even real art and whatever. And it's really easy to get pissed off when you're looking at the art stock market and you see something that is like $3 million and it's like one brushstroke, right? But you're looking at it completely out of context.
Mm-hmm.
You're not looking at the story behind it, the reason that it, I mean, nothing should be that expensive. That's a whole other ball of wax. But to minimize the value of something because it's something that you don't understand or you don't do yourself.
Or it just happens to be not your thing.
Or it happens not to be your thing. I think that that's a lot of, there's a lot of people out there that think that they have license to tell you what is real art and what isn't. And the truth is that nobody fucking knows. Nobody knows. Nobody knows. You look at all contemporary art, or look at any of the old art, modern art, it's all across the board. All across the board. There's a freaking urinal that is considered real art, right? There is crayon paintings. There are construction paper cutouts that are considered real art, you know? So anybody that's out there is like, well, that's not real art. They could eat a bag.
Mm-hmm.
That's where I'm at with that.
Luke said, this is so great. I've only recently called myself a professional artist after selling art for years. And now I've been asked to judge an elementary school art show. I feel so validated more than ever.
Isn't that fun? I love stuff like that. John, oh, thank you, John.
Thank you, John. Thanks for making
the world a better place. Oh, thank you
so much. Sandy said, a guy said to me, my kid could do that. I said, good. If he can, he can earn his own way through college. I love it.
That is brilliant. I love that, Sandy.
Watercolor added, everything's made up, by the way. All beliefs are made up. I know, right? I'd be like, well, I'm not a real person. I'm like 99% empty space. Oh, so like, you know, here's my art.
Kelly said, reminds me of the guy who told me the price of my pen and inks should be low because they're not oils. He was an a-hole.
He was probably just mad because he wanted to buy one and couldn't afford it.
Yeah. Yeah, and that's always a great answer. That's an answer that I've given people when they're like, well, this is a little expensive. I'm like, yeah, my art's not for everybody. It's like,
yeah.
What do you want me to say?
Is it a mean thing to say? Is it a nice thing to say? Who knows? It depends on the person hearing it.
Exactly.
Jin just said, anyone claiming you're not making real art is clearly not the sharpest knife in the crayon box. I love that.
A bag of cocktail weenies. Yes, that's right.
Robot Rabbit said, I just say art is a myth. Usually pauses the conversation long enough to excuse yourself to grab another drink.
That's so good. I like it. I love it.
Daniel said, when people look at art and say, what? I could do that. I say, well, you didn't, did you? You didn't even imagine it.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I had that experience when I did my very first time showing art was the Museum of Contemporary Art in Chicago. And I had an art show and this family that was friends of my ex-wife came and the husband came up and said, oh, so did your kids help you with that? Right. To some of my abstracts. And I was like, yes, they did. They're extremely talented. Extremely talented.
Mm-hmm. Pretty soon they'll be having their own art shows here.
Yeah, pretty soon they'll be having their own art shows. But I remember it's still, you know, it was in the early days and I was so insecure and it took a big bite out of me.
Yeah.
And I'm like, you know, now I think about it, I'm like, oh, come at me, bro. Like, that would be amazing. Come at me. I've got so many, like, quips for you. And, like, I really don't care what you say. You know, and that's where I am. But it's only been because I have been doing this and putting my stuff out there. And I've gotten way worse comments than that. That's actually a nice comment. But I've gotten to a place, and this happens for everybody. You get to a place where someone could literally walk up to you and say, your art is a piece of shit. And I can look at them and be like, thanks. And then walk away and then completely delete the, you know, like, I don't care. Like, I don't. Great. You found it necessary to say that? Good for you.
One man's piece of shit is another man's fertilizer.
That's right.
Christina asks, so should one consider what effect one wants to invoke in other people? Like, I want people to think X is beautiful along with I want to create beauty.
I would say don't do that because you have no control over the emotions that you will invoke in other people. But you do have a handle on what things evoke emotion in you.
Yeah.
So really, really create, you know, when you create the work for yourself, that's what it means. Like, you want to evoke that emotion in you. And the cool thing about that is that it will attract those kind of people. Right.
Right. That resonate.
And it might repel the other kind of people.
Which is good too.
That's good too.
Yeah. That's what I also think about is how do I want to feel at the end of this? What feelings am I trying to evoke from myself? And that's the ultimate goal for me, is to achieve that with whatever it is. And yeah, exactly what you said. Then the people that are going to resonate are going to resonate.
Yep.
And we are over our time.
We are. We got to go, you guys.
We are having Rafi, lots of fun.
Rafi, round one, fight, a-hole. What? Rafi swinging a sculpture. That would be amazing.
And Rafi comes in with the chair. Unbelievable, said Jesse. You guys are the best.
You guys are awesome. Love you guys. This was great. Love hanging out. Love these conversations. This is like sit around a bonfire and let's talk about the realities of the art world, not the humdrum, boring bullshit that a lot of people love to talk about. Don't get me wrong, a lot of people love talking about it. There are a few artists on YouTube that are amazing. I love them. I can't remember anybody's name, but just saying.
They're out there.
They're out there. And then there are some that I'm like, just shut up. Just don't do that. Don't talk about that.
New England says, I always think of comebacks hours later in the shower. And the good thing about that is then you can just put that comeback in your pocket.
Just put it in your pocket.
Next time somebody says this thing, I'm going to have this on the ready.
I'm going to say something before we go, because I think that this is important, where you put that in. Remember, like, you'll have an experience, right? Somebody will come in, say something, and then later on you're like, ooh, I should have said this, right? That's fine, because it's always a work in progress. Mm-hmm. You're fine tuning your responses the more that they happen, right? So it's important not to get discouraged, or it's especially important not to beat yourself up because maybe you allowed it to get to you or something like that, right? You don't want to compound the negative experience with that crap. You know, be good to yourself and sure, think up those things and be like, all right, great. I can't do anything about that experience other than be good to myself and be like, all right, that's fine. Next time, if something like that happens, boom, I've got it. Next time, exactly. If it happens, I've got it. That's the reason that the stuff with the art doesn't bother me, because it's been next time, you know, I'm going to do this. Next time, I'm going to say this.
That is the growth experience.
The art of cold-blooded comeback is a lifelong practice.
It totally is. Thank you to all of you guys who hit the like button, and thank you to all of you guys who are encouraging people to hit the like button. It is greatly appreciated.
Thank you, guys.
Robot Rabbit said, what about a book of Klee's one-liners and wisdom?
Oh, it's going to happen. It's going to happen.
That could be fun.
I want to release the tree wisdom t-shirts. So we'll be doing that as soon as we have time to like work on them. But
yeah.
I've been dying to put together a Klee book. Klee wisdom book. It's going to be amazing. When they disparage your art, just say, I bet your mother told you to say that. Those are all so good.
I like that so much.
Love you guys. Thanks for all you do. Love you too. You guys are amazing. Klee plurisms. Oh, that's good.
Klee forisms. Yeah.
Klee forisms.
That is good.
All right. I think, what am I doing? I just got lost. I got lost. Okay, here we go.
Okay.
Thank you, guys. This was fun.
I'm still reading their comments.